Let's take a look at an example involving graphing motion, and we're going to start with this graph. It is a graph of velocity versus time for some object. Notice that we've got the axes labeled, where we've got time here and velocity here. The object begins at 4 meters per second, and the velocity declines as time goes on until it reaches a velocity of 0 meters per second after 8 seconds have elapsed. And so what we'd like to do is convert this into an acceleration versus time graph and a position versus time graph. So, how do we do that? The easiest thing to do is to start with acceleration versus time. If we do that, we can say, all right, acceleration versus time over 8 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And to determine acceleration, acceleration is going to be equal to our change in velocity over our change in time. And so our change in velocity was, well, we went from 4 meters per second to zero, so our change was a negative 4 meters per second, and that happened over 8 seconds. And so what we get is, well, 4 over 8 is 1/2. So we get negative 1/2 meters per second squared. And that is our acceleration, which means I need to bring down my axis into the negative. So if this is going to be our acceleration in meters per second squared, then if this is 1, negative 1, there's positive 1, negative 1/2 meters per second squared is going to be right here. And because the slope of our velocity versus time graph is constant, the acceleration at all moments is constant. So we'll have constant acceleration continuing on across all of these time durations, all of these time intervals. So negative 1/2. So there's our acceleration versus time graph. Now let's take a look at position, which we'll call x, and that'll be in meters divided by, or meters over seconds, like that. Well, generally, what we'll see is there's going to be a negative acceleration, which means that as time goes on, the slope of our x versus time graph should not be constant. Why? Because the slope of x versus time, which is going to be the change in x over change in time, y, change in y over change in x-axis, well, that's equal to the velocity. And notice how velocity is changing, which means if it's changing to be a smaller number, we start with a higher slope and end with a lower slope. And so the way that we can do that is by, as each second goes by, we can draw something that looks like this. A higher slope, slightly less high slope, this, like so. So we could either draw something that looks like this, or if, because we have a positive velocity, we should be traveling in the positive x direction. So we can start with a high slope and then end up with a low slope looking like that. So this is probably what our graph is going to look like right here. All right, but how do we describe this motion? Well, that means we're moving in the positive x direction. And as we move in the positive x direction, we are traveling a shorter displacement as each second goes on. That is, we're making less and less progress as each second goes on because we're losing velocity. We are decelerating until finally we get to a zero acceleration. Until finally we get to a zero velocity, and at that point the object stops and is at rest. A couple other things that we can do. We can determine how far we have traveled during this 8 second duration. In order to figure that out, we can use our graph. Well, remember that the displacement is equal to velocity times change in time. Well, we can do that. So take a look at our graph over here. It turns out that displacement from a velocity versus time graph can be given by the area under the curve. Because velocity times time is going to be equal to our displacement. But the velocity changes. So it can't just be the rectangle here. It's going to be this triangle. So we'll have to divide the area of what would be the rectangle by half. So the triangle area, well, that's going to be equal to the area of a triangle is equal to 1/2 base times height. So in this case, it'll be 1/2 times 8 seconds times the height, which is going to be 4 meters per second. So what we get is 8 times 4 times 1/2, which gives us 16 meters. Notice how the seconds cancel out. So our displacement, total displacement in x, is 16 meters. That's how far we travel as we are decelerating from 4 meters per second to 0 over the course of 8 seconds.